Ladies, you can start whenever you're ready.
What if this phone that you use daily can actually save lives? We are HerLens. We save women's life by turning this phone into a tool for cervical cancer screening. Meet Alfie, our co-founder, and her mom. Back in 2022, her mom had a routine cervical cancer screening checkup at a small clinic and was told everything was fine. But few months later, they found that she was misdiagnosed and already reached late stage of cervical cancer. We lost her soon after. We do not want this to happen to anyone else. The test accuracy is only 66% accurate. These inaccurate tests have led to 90,000 deaths every year. Today, doctors screen by applying acetic acid to the cervix, waiting for 1 minute to see if there is discoloration using their naked eye. But relying on the naked eye itself is not enough because the discoloration is not distinct in early stage.
We need to do something about it. So we created HerLens, an extra layer of confirmation using AI. We attach a camera to the speculum, connecting it to our app to capture a high quality images and ensure a more accurate diagnosis happens. To be clear, we are not replacing the process, we are enhancing it. With AI, the more tests we screen, the better the accuracy. And we are on track to improve the test to 98% accuracy by the time we pass all the regulations. Screening isn't just limited to hospital anymore. With HerLens, doctors aren't the only healthcare workers who can administer the test. We are training more local health workers to conduct the screenings, making it easier for women to get tested. Our main customers are healthcare facilities. In Indonesia, hospitals and public health offices oversee clinics, and HerLens will be distributed to the health workers. We sell test kits and charge an annual fee for access to our app. Unlike our competitor, we are the best choice for a cost-effective solutions because we are more portable, easier to set up, and more advanced. 2 weeks ago, we signed an agreement with Indonesia's largest hospital. This hospital owns 340 clinics in Jakarta. They ordered 40,000 screening tests, generating $340,000 in revenue. Indonesia's Ministry of Health has allocated $4.6 billion to fight cervical cancer, $2.5 billion dedicated solely for screening, funding hospital to pay HerLens, and the test is free for patients. By the end of this year, we will pilot our project and pass the first regulatory stage. Next year, we will be fully compliant with all Indonesia's regulation and launch with our hospital partner and their hundreds of clinics. By 2029, HerLens will be available across Indonesia's healthcare facilities. In 2030, we will expand to the Southeast Asia, beginning with Philippines and Cambodia, where similar cervical cancer challenges exist. With the $1 million, we will focus on R&D, regulatory approval, and expansion, with a goal to screen 5 million of women.
By 2030, we aim to detect 95% of early-stage cervical cancer, potentially saving 59 million women's lives. I'm Salsa, the CPO leading product design.
And I'm Andini, the CEO leading our strategic business moves.
Together with our team of experts, we are the perfect team to build HerLens. We're also backed by the board of advisors. If HerLens had existed back then, Alfie's mom might be cheering with us now in this crowd. Thank you.
Congratulations. Congratulations, great job. I'd like to open to questions from the judges.
Thank you for a very clear statement of the opportunity. I want to know more about your AI, which is very important. Discoloration can be dependent on the original skin color and whatnot. Are you preparing, how are you going to get the data that is going to give you the AI accuracy? And do you believe that that can be acquired across differences in ethnicity?
Okay, so currently we get our AI from our partner hospital in one of the Indonesia's largest hospitals, where we currently attain 1,297 cervical images. And by these images, we can have the accuracy of 85%. And if you total it with the current accuracy from the naked eye, it could be 95%. And for the scaling AI in across the countries and across Indonesia, so currently the cervical images is the same for all of these for all of the Southeast Asian countries, because all of the people in our South Asian countries have the same demographical and anatomy.
So just to be clear, have you actually got a prototype that you've tested, and what have been the results of those tests?
Okay, so currently we already tested our prototype with our partner in Indonesia's largest hospital, and the test accuracy is 85% from our hospital. And other than that, we also have tested this to 150 women with 50 trained health workers.
You talked about misdiagnosis, and probably in early stages of your testing, a misdiagnosis might occur. What happens in that case?
Sorry, could you rephrase the questions?
You talked about misdiagnosis, and in early stages of your prototyping and testing this to the market, a misdiagnosis might occur by using your platform, right? What happens if it occurs using your platform?
So we still depends on the health worker's capacity. So that's why with the combination, we believe it's our AI is a part of the second opinion, and we still need the judge from the healthcare worker. So even if the misdiagnosis happen with our AI, we still have the health workers as the second layer of ensuring the misdiagnosis will not happen.
What kind of training do the healthcare workers need?
So for the training, they need the training to use our mobile application for HerLens, because currently the knowledge of trained healthcare workers, especially in rural areas, is low for the mobile application. So that's why we need to train them first to use the HerLens. But apart from that, currently they already have the method to use the mobile phone. So it is not something new. We're just adding the process, not replacing it.
I can certainly appreciate why it's better than the naked eye. But coming back to your competitor slide, is that because you're more accurate, you're using AI, you're cheaper? Maybe people are not being very fair to the consumer. How would you characterize that competitor slide in a little bit more detail?
Okay, so besides we are more accurate than all of this competitor, we are also adapt with the low resource area. We want to ensure this because what we want to tackle is the low resource area settings. And also we provide a more portable one and more easier for them to access, which is the mobile phone that they already have now.
Are you processing the images on the phone or on the cloud for privacy issues?
So we will process it with the
Thank
cloud.
Thank you very much, HerLens.